Pawar, and I am today I'm going to present crew resource management topic, and I'm pursuing MBA aviation second year student, and currently I'm doing aircrew internship in aircrew aviation as a aviation manager. So let's begin with the presentation. So what is basically the CRM? So CRM is a crew resource management. It is the effective use of all available resources for the flight crew personnel and to assure the safe flight. Not only the safe, but also the efficient operation. It also reduces the error. It avoids the stress over the pilot or cabin crews. And it also increases the efficiency in day-to-day operations. So what is the goal of CRM? Why it has designed? Why it is needed? So the primary goal of CRM is to enhance the situational awareness, self-awareness, leadership, assertiveness, decision-making, flexibility, adaptability, and event over the mission analysis and communication. So that is the main purpose of crew resource management or cockpit resource management. You can also call it a cockpit resource management. So let's have a smaller look over the history of CRM. It was initiated by NASA psychologist John Labor, and has discovered the crash due to lack of internal communication. Second is poor decision making and lack of leadership skills. So basically, all over these 3 points, the CRM works. So synopsis of CRM is cockpit resource management, as I said. So next one is flight deck resource management and command. A third one is leadership and resource management. And next is crew resource management. So also the CRM techniques are applied for other areas like maintenance resource management. So basically, you can also use the CRM for maintenance, aircraft maintenance purposes. So what exactly the CRM consists of? What it possesses? The CRM training encompasses a wide range of knowledge. It also develops the skills, attitude, including communication, also the situational awareness, problem solving, and decision making, and teamwork. It develops among the crew by the training. And also together with the attendant, it also develops the disciplines which each of these areas are entails. So about the brief of the CRM. CRM is concerned with the cognitive and interpersonal skills needed to manage the resources within an organized system. Organizes the whole flight deck so that pilot does not get confused with the day-to-day operations. It also not much with the technical knowledge and skills required to the operate the equipment. Skill part is covered in the training of the pilots. So not much advanced technique. You should not have advanced technical knowledge for using the CRM techniques. So what exactly the cognitive skills CRM inculcates in the pilots or cabin crew? The cognitive skills are defined as the mental process used for gaining and maintaining situational awareness for solving the problems and making the decision. So it's basically it is a support system for the pilot's decision making. We can say that. So what are the worldwide use of CRM? CRM training for crew has been introduced and developed by the aviation organizations. ITA has developed the CRM organization. Even the NTSB, National Transport Safety Bureau, has introduced the CRM in the worldwide, even in the commercial aviation and also in the military aviation. So the following the lead of the commercial airline industry, the U.S. Department of Defense also began the formal training its aircrew in CRM in the mid of 1980s. Presently, the US Air Force and US Navy require all aircrew members to receive annual CRM training. So they provide the annual CRM training, refresher courses, etc. In an effort to reduce the human error cause mishap, because 80% of accidents are caused by human error. So the US Army has its own version of CRM called Aircrew Coordination Training Enhanced. So short form is ACTE. So CRM can be used as the to create the situational awareness, self awareness. It also develops the leadership quality in the pilot as far as aviation is concerned. It also develops the assertiveness, decision making, flexibility, adaptability, event and mission analysis, and the communication. Specifically, the CRM aims to foster the climate or the culture where the authority may be respectfully questioned. Suppose explain this topic, suppose there is one senior and junior pilot. So junior pilot sometimes it is a human behavior. Sometimes he cannot be sure about his doubt. Should he ask or not? He will be in that dilemma. So CRM helps to find out this kind of solution for that particular person. So it was recognized that there was a need for a system to assess pilots' CRM skills, taking note of this delicacy of the matter. Means it also helps in a proper communication for the pilot, and it reduces the human error, and it also prevents the incidents and accidents. So CRM trainings are consist of lectures, theoretical lectures. Then the case they give pilots to case study reviews. Then audio and videos. Whatever the previous errors caused by the pilots, so that they can avoid this kind of things. The newer batch of the pilot can avoid the previous errors, and practical exercises. Line-oriented flight training, that is LOFT role play. We will see about line-oriented flight training. Then annual retraining, that is the refresher courses, and line operation safety audits. So what is line operation safety audits? It is a real-life data collection. The training will provide the actual scenario, real life events to the pilots, and how they will observe how the pilot will handle that situation. So that will be monitored by the CRM and authorities. They will also monitor the flight deck crew operations, threats and errors, and how those kind of threats and error can be managed. So CRM skills evaluates and records the action taken by the pilots. It's also, it also suggests the non-jeopardy conditions to the pilot. And data used for the training development, previous data used for the training and development, so that in the future, pilot will not, occur the same error. So what kind of disadvantage of CRM is there? So it has got the higher implementation cost, higher maintenance cost, and rules variation according to the authority of the country. Rules variation means India has got another regulatory body, and US has got another regulatory body. So the some kinds of variation will be there. So CRM, as per the authority, this CRM can be updated. So this kind of advantages we have to face in the CRM. So Thank you. That is the end of the topic. And one more, quote is there. So there is simply no substitute for experience in terms of aviation safety, said by Chesley Sullenberger. So, safety is priority in the aviation sector. So, of course, CRM is playing major part in this safety. So, thank you so much. Any questions?